In this semester, our project title is Plaster Ceiling Protector. In our group that consists of three members, Rachel will be our leader, and Caleb and me, Ray. So there are four learning outcomes in this module. First will be define what a successful project is. Second, explain project management project groups. LO3 will be apply technique to manage and balance scope, schedule, cost, resources, and other aspects of the project. And lastly, for LO4, evaluate the success or failure of the project. This is a brief background on our project. During installation and uninstallation of the downlight PC, the plaster ceiling will be damaged by the spring that attached on the casing. So this is the picture attached here as an example how the plaster ceiling is damaged. So our main objective for this project is to protect the plaster ceiling from damage during the installation and uninstallation of the downlight casing. So there are the project management process consists of five processes, namely initiating, planning, executing, control, and monitoring, and lastly closing. So for the first will be the first process will be initiating. There'll be under initiating there are priority analysis, stakeholders, and risk assessment. The project consists of four priority aspects. There will be schedule, scope, quality, and budget. These are the four aspects to have a successful project. So for our schedule, we plan to finish our project within 13 weeks. Our scope will be to protect the plaster ceiling, which is our main objective. For budget, we catered our budget to be within 100 ringgit. And for our quality of our product, our product can maintain for 10 years without maintenance. So next element will be the stakeholder. The sponsor will be from Taylor's School of Engineering. Module coordinator will be Mr. Jeffrey. Design lecturer, Dr. Edwin. Supervisor is also Dr. Edwin. Project leader will be Wei Shen, as mentioned during the first slide. Project team will be Caleb, T. Lee Jun, and Teo Wei Wei. Manufacturing advisors, lab assistants, and the end user will be contractor and subcontractor. Finally, the risk assessment. There are four possible risks that may occur during the process of building our project. So, the first risk will be inhaling the powder of plaster ceiling when cutting it. The next risk, the powder of plaster ceiling get into the eyes when cutting it. The third one, cut by cutting tool during the cutting process. And lastly, cut the sharp edges of the metal. With the risk assessment, we can minimize or prevent the possibility of getting hurt during the entire process of building our project.
This is the work breakdown structure of our project. We break it into product design, product management, and manufacturing of the product. Under product design, we use observe, understand, ideate, and prototype to execute our project. Under product management, we use initiate, planning, executing, control and monitoring, and closing to monitor the progress of our project. Lastly, we will send our prototype to be manufactured by factory and ready to be sold at the market. This is the estimated budget of our project, which has a total of 45 ringgit and 30 cents. We plan to finish our project within 13 weeks. The third process, executing, which includes managing people, leadership, and managing team or project. As for managing people, we conduct meetings at least once a week. In terms of leadership, work are evenly divided by the leader. With this structured arrangement, the project will progress smoothly. In terms of managing team, we usually communicate using social media such as Facebook and WhatsApp. We follow our plan accordingly and work as a team. The fourth process is control and monitoring, which includes schedule, budget, and quality. There are four factors that cause the project to delay. These factors are: projects are new, unexpected risk, communication breakdown, and last minute work. As for our project, we plan a project timeline before the project started. Hence, we can finish our project on time. In terms of budget, we exceeded our estimated budget. This is because we did not take our failure into account. In terms of quality, we do a lot of testing. This is to ensure that our project is quality controlled.
The fifth process is closing, which includes final adjustment, reviewing performance, and documentation. As for our project, it is considered as a successful project. This is because our product can protect plaster ceiling from damaging during the installation and uninstallation of the downlight casing. As we can see in the photo, if the original downlight casing is used, the plaster ceiling will be damaged. If our improved downlight casing is used, the plaster ceiling will not be damaged. Okay. Now we are showing our product.
These two metal plates are our products. Since the spring is the root cause, we decided to replace it with zinc metal plate. To install downlight casing to the plaster ceiling, we need to place our design zinc metal plate to the downlight casing. Then it is inserted through the hole of the plaster ceiling. Okay, stop. Then push the metal plate towards the plaster ceiling. This is how our product supports the downlight casing. To uninstall the downlight casing, a screwdriver is needed. First, the screwdriver is inserted to the hole of the metal plate. Then pull the metal plate out. As we can see from the surface of the plaster ceiling, there is no damage on it.
Thank you.